The Wheel of Food always suggests for me two breakfasts every week. One of them is an egg breakfast, and the other one is a non-egg breakfast that might have an egg ingredient, but it's not an egg all by itself. So this week, what did it come up with? Avocado toast, one of my favorites. So I mentioned I always get two breakfast suggestions, but in this case I said avocado toast. Well, that's because one avocado is gonna make me two breakfasts. So for the egg-based breakfast, it's gonna be an avocado toast with a poached egg. For the non-egg one, it's gonna be an avocado garlic toast. I've got the ingredients for my first avocado toast. So avocado, my egg to poach, some lemon to preserve the avocado color, some vinegar for the poached egg, salt, pepper, and Saran Wrap for preserving my avocado. Now, you might notice there's a little bit of brown flecks on this. This avocado is actually like 2 weeks old. I can't believe it's still green enough that I can use it. I'm very happy about that. To preserve an avocado once it's cut, leave the pit in to help preserve it, put lemon juice all over it, and then Saran Wrap. So there it is, all wrapped up with Saran Wrap, touching the flesh as much as possible. Pit also helping out. Hopefully this thing will last until tomorrow's avocado toast. In the meantime, let's learn how to poach an egg. We're gonna start by boiling lots of water. The cool thing about poaching an egg is that it only takes about 3 minutes. I have boiling water, which I'm now taking off the heat because I want it to be nice and still, but super hot. I'm gonna add to it some salt and some vinegar. The vinegar is supposed to help the white wrap around the yolk better. A lot of people swear by the vortex technique where you spin the water and then drop the egg into the spinning water and the vortex will help wrap the white around the yolk. I've really never bothered with that. Shout out to Ruth and Allie for my little bowls, and in goes the egg. I'm letting this go 3 minutes and you can see the white's a little bit loose. It'll firm up a bit. But they say that a brand new egg will poach best because it stays tight. But for soft-boiled eggs, it's easier to peel an old egg. So you could use that. Soft-boiled old, poach new. For my avocado, I'm gonna actually put it into this little bowl here, and I'm gonna mash it up with a little bit of lemon juice, salt, and pepper, and then I'll use that as my spread for my bread. The bread is toasting. When you think the egg is ready, 3 minutes have gone by, you can actually pick it up with a slotted spoon, and you can actually tell that looks like it's not quite there yet. So I'm gonna let it go just a little bit longer. Once the egg is poached, usually about 3 minutes, possibly a tiny bit more, you drain out the water, and then you also dab it on a folded up paper towel. And then you'll transfer it to your bread. You can also put a little salt and pepper on there if you'd like. And there she is, avocado toast number one. I'm thinking I actually maybe, instead of wrapping that one up in cellophane with the pit, I could have actually made it into the garlic avocado now and then put cellophane over the top of that. Anyway, check it out. Here we go. Oh, yeah. I'm sure I'm supposed to knife and fork this, but anyway, avocado toast, two ways, way one. Tomorrow with garlic. For now, oh yeah. Mm-hmm. So good. It's so much better than... It's my second day with my avocado toast experiment, and this time I'm supposed to be putting raw garlic into the avocado instead of putting an egg on top, because it's the non-egg day. So I'm gonna try that. I feel a little bit like that's a lot, like raw garlic right into the avocado directly, but let's see how it goes. So there's my avocado. Still looks very green after 2 days already opened up. Someone told me I should get one of those avocado savers. That sounds good because I think it would be better on the environment than using Saran Wrap. I found the smallest garlic I could, so in it goes. There she is, avocado toast, this time with garlic in it, raw garlic, and some tomatoes just to bulk it up. So let's see what we think. Here's the thing. Raw garlic is pretty sharp. It's actually mellowed out after, I tried it right when I first mixed it together and it was pretty bold. But now with the bread and a couple of minutes of rest, it actually is pretty awesome. It's definitely garlicky. And I think this little slice of tomato is gonna cool it right now.